right. What I'd like to do is go through the cognitive skills for attending class. This tends to be a very helpful and relevant example for everyone in breaking down the different levels of cognition. So let's just go through those levels of cognition again. We have arousal, just being awake and ready for stimulus, orientation to the person, the time, and the place, attention either between two stimuluses or sustained attention, directing your attention towards one stimulus, or divided attention, where you're going in between two different stimuli. We have memory, where we're holding that information either for immediate retrieval, a short-term retrieval, or long-term over the many years. And then we have the executive functions of problem-solving. If something happens, what do we need to do about it? Time management and inferencing, more for those abstract ideas. So let's go through normal attending of class. To just get to class, we have to be aroused. You have to be awake. You probably had to catch the bus or walk or drive to class. And so that already requires a level of arousal. To be oriented to the time and the place and the person, you're oriented that you are on campus at LSU. You understand that you are in a classroom. You understand the rules that are in that classroom. You sit down, you open your laptop or your notebook. You're taking notes. You're listening to the instructor. And for attention, you're sustaining your attention with the instructor and listening to what they have to say. If you sustain your attention long enough, then you are encoding and interpreting that information to be stored into memory. Whether it's stored into short-term or long-term memory depends on how you use that information later. So if you don't go back and review your notes, it's likely that the information that you review in class is going to stay either in working memory, where you can't recall very much after you walk out the door, or short-term memory, where you might be able to have enough information to help you study for an exam, versus long-term memory, you're taking notes, you're sustaining your attention in what the instructor says, you have limited distractions in the environment around you, and so it's more likely to make it to long-term memory if you supplement that information after class by reviewing your notes again, talking about that information with your peers or your instructor or your family members or your friends. And then for problem solving, time management, and inferencing, say you get a text message in the middle of class. Your problem solving skills say, I need to sustain my attention for taking notes, and so do I choose to answer the text message and read it, or do I continue holding that attention in class and taking notes and understand the topics that are going on? For time management, you really don't have a choice once you enter the classroom. The class is typically an hour and a half long, but you do understand that you don't need to schedule anything in the middle of class time where you'd have to leave or not attend class at all. Once class is over, you understand where you need to go next. You either need to go to your next class, or you need to go to work, or maybe you have a free day afterwards. And that time management says if you have a friend in the class afterwards, you don't need to talk to them for very long afterwards if you have to get to class. And then inferencing really is involved in the information and that input during the classroom. So the teacher, right now I'm giving you an example, you're inferencing that, you might be applying it to your own life and what you do, and you might say, oh, I don't do that. Or, oh yeah, I'm doing that, I'm doing great. And you're inferencing the humor in the voice of the professor. If the professor comes in a little disheveled, you might inference that something happened beforehand, or might inference something about their personality overall. So you can see that attending class really does involve all of the levels of cognition, and the ability to hold that information in the long term really is impacted by those lower levels of cognition. If you are using your attention or your memory appropriately during the class time. So let's go through a situation where you're kind of hitting all the levels of cognition in your ability to attend class and sustain your attention throughout that class. So for beginning with arousal, let's imagine that you were studying really hard for another exam in another class the night before, and you continued to study after only getting 3 hours of sleep right before class started, and kept studying even though you knew that it took 10 minutes to get to class and you only had 5 left. And so you're already at a poor level of arousal. You have limited sleep. You might have had a cup of coffee on the way to work or on the way to class. So that makes you over-aroused. You're already losing a little bit of your attention. Somebody called you that threw you off, and you're just overexcited. You get to class, and for orientation, you know that you're in the classroom. You know that you're supposed to abide by these unspoken rules of opening your laptop and taking notes or opening your notebook. But instead, you open up the chat on your laptop, or you open up your phone. Or maybe you take out your planner and start planning everything for the next week or color coding things. So you're violating those rules within the classroom of taking notes and participating in that lecture. As far as attention goes, once you've gone into the realm of opening up a planner or opening up texts or watching a video or shopping, you're dividing your attention. And despite popular belief, humans really don't divide their attention very well. So you think, oh, I'm doing six things at once in an hour and a half. I've bought a pair of sunglasses. I looked up an article for another class. I answered an email from my boss. I answered a text message from my friends. And I got seven sentences on paper from my class. Ultimately, that's going to impact your ability to recall that information later. You're not encoding it and storing it in memory, whether that's in working memory, short-term memory, or long-term memory. So think about the last time you walked out of a classroom. You have no idea what the instructor said, even though you think you paid attention for at least 10 minutes of that lecture. That's because your attention was pulled in so many different directions, it could never encode that information for you to use. Once we get into the executive functions, you can see that you're already impacted your problem-solving skills. Maybe the professor asks you a question, and you have the choice to say, I don't know the answer because I wasn't paying attention, even though you might leave that part off, or to lie about it and hope that you get it right, or just accept that you're going to get it wrong, but try anyway. And that can impact the perception of the instructor and the students in the classroom if you do have that type of situation. Maybe you're on your phone and the professor caught you, and you have the problem-solving skill of either getting off your phone immediately or ignoring the professor and continuing to be on your phone. For time management, you've obviously violated the rules of time management because you think that you're completing 2, 3, 6 tasks at once, but really you're dividing that attention among them instead of using your time wisely in the classroom. For inferencing, if an instructor is going on about a topic and you're supposed to be applying it to your life or applying it to the previous information that was covered in the class, and you have no idea what the instructor is talking about, you've lost that ability to inference. So what I hope you learn from this is that cognition really is an important thing, and you don't have to have cognitive deficits or an injury to the brain for cognition to be impacted. You impact your cognition every day throughout the day by the choices that you make and the activities that you do. In order to work your cognitive levels to the best of your ability, it's recommended to do the things that help. You know, get a good night's rest. Be oriented to where you are. Understand that you have roles and responsibilities within certain times, and you have the ability to take the information during those periods and carry it over into other areas. You can see that little things throw your cognitive ability off, and so making good choices can impact your overall ability to attend class and apply that information later, and ultimately that makes studying easier.